Hey, my name's Ivan, and this is another off-grid solar-powered energy-efficient tiny or maybe not so tiny house that I've built with my own hands in the mountains of Bulgaria. Well, technically, I've built almost everything you can see in this frame, so let's dive in and I'll tell you all the small details about this project, shall we? In the previous video about my house, I told you guys that I built another one for my neighbor. So this is the house I was talking about. They are in the same location, 300 meters from each other. Obviously they share this beautiful mountain view, and I was actually building them simultaneously, so they're very similar in terms of materials and technology. It is a timber frame on a foundation of concrete pillars with rockwool insulation, drywall on the inside, huge panoramic windows, and natural wooden facade on the outside. The main differences are the dimensions, the layout, the solar installation capabilities, basically the scale of everything. So if you want to know more about the construction process, be my guest and watch my previous video on this channel. This house is 15 by 4.5 meters, which makes it about 67 square meters or 720 square feet. There is also a beautiful terrace of almost 80 square meters all around the house, with a cozy resting area designed for a firepit. Unlike my house, which is a completely open space, this one has several spaces in it. From the entrance we get into the huge living room of almost 40 square meters that opens a really stunning view on the mountains. The right window is the main entrance, and I'm saying main because there is another one that I'm gonna show you later. The middle one is fixed, and the left one can also be opened to get to an access to the terrace. This makes the space feel even more open and kinda gives it more air. Initially we'd planned to put a sofa here in this space and even saved some room in the heated floors for that. But as the family started spending more and more time here, they asked me to build a Murphy bed here on this wall, which I'm already working on. There is also an AC to cool down the place, and a movie projector for the cozy family movie nights. This part of the space is the kitchen, and I think it's super cozy. I love the way how the guys decorated it. It features absolutely everything you might have in a city apartment, like an oven, an induction cooktop, a full-size sink, a dishwasher, and this beautiful two-winged fridge with the freezer to keep your drinks ice cold. And I think the absolute gem of this space is this kitchen island slash table to cook with the family and enjoy a meal with your friends. From the living room we get into a small entree with a mirror that leads to the bathroom, which is done in the same style as mine but with small alterations. The walls here also feature travertine finish, and again, if you want to see how it's done, check out my previous video. As well as my bathroom, it also has a urinal toilet, a normal flushing toilet, a full-size shower. I also made those niches for the products that come extremely handy. Here is a small sink, and there's gonna be a mirror on top of it. The door here is different to mine though, as we wanted it to match the other doors in the house. And finally from here we get to the last room in this house, that is something between a technical room and a storage room. Basically it's something like a nervous system of the whole place, as all the communications are here in those cabinets. Here is the electrical installation, and you can definitely see my overkill in style here. We have our solar inverters, the lithium ferrum phosphate battery. Here on top you can see the Wi-Fi relays that control the lights and the power supplies for the cameras. Here in the left cabinet sit the electrical water heater, and the water filtering system that is connected to the pump. Finally, there is a second door that I mentioned before. It opens away to the terrace in the back of the house, and that's about it when it comes to the layout. And yes, this barbecue is not meant here, it's gonna sit in the outside barbie that I'll show you in a bit. Frankly, even for me, after doing all this, it's still kinda hard to believe that there was an empty field here and then I built all of this, like what? But still, here we are, and I'm very proud of this one. So, let's dive into the specs of what makes this house kinda big brother to mine, starting with the solar installation. I've used the same model of panels, HiKu7 by Canadian Solar, 660 watts each, forming two arrays by 7 panels, connected in series and giving a total of 9 kilowatts of peak power. My neighbor's hobby is woodworking and he wanted to have enough power not to think about the power at all, so we installed two of SPF 5000 ES inverters by Growatt, 5 kilowatts each, working in parallel and giving us 10 kilowatts of power, which is more than enough to power everything in this house, including some heavy loads like a welding machine, for example. The only thing that is smaller in comparison with my power plant is the battery capacity. It features the same cells and BMS by Overkill Solar that you could see in the previous video, but here we only have one of those, while I have two. The reason for that was that the family doesn't live here permanently. They only use this house as a villa, so they don't need much of a saving capacity, while the huge solar array provides enough power during the day for the AC or heated floors. So in total, my neighbor has 280 amp hours of lithium ferrum phosphate or 15 kilowatt hours of energy. On the roof of the house, we've installed a lightning protection system that is connected to the grounding rod, so the house and the appliances in the house are safe during thunderstorms. The water in this house is supplied by a well that is 56 meters deep and has a yield of 8,000 liters per day. Practically speaking, that is more than enough, but again, I love overkills and being on the safe side, so we've buried a 5,000 liters tank next to the house for the freshwater reserve. The tank is filled automatically whenever the level is low, so the neighbor always has enough fresh water to use in the house or to water the grass and the yard. There is also a heating cable laid down with the pipes, so the system is safe during the cold in the winter. I've also finished my little experiment with rainwater collection at my house. It was fun, but as I said in the first video, having a well is way better, so now my house is also connected to the same well. A couple of months ago, I laid all the piping, reinforced the underground tank with the metal structure, and completely rerouted the whole thing, so now, thanks to my neighbor, I also have an unlimited supply of fresh water. The Greywater system is absolutely the same as mine, but again, bigger. There is a PVC recycling tank of 2500 liters buried in the back part of the land and connected to the house with 50 meters of PVC pipes. All the outlets are connected under the house and go into the main master pipe. Apart from the house, I've also built a small tool shed that is used to keep all kinds of stuff like tools and, for example, a lawnmower. And finally, the latest build of this project was this beautiful barbecue with a lifting door and a firewood storage compartment on the side. I've also filmed the whole thing, so if you want to see the details, leave a comment down below and I'll make a separate video on that. So, that was the house that I built for my neighbor at the same time I was building mine, and that was a crazy ongoing mix of everything everywhere all at once, happening at the same time. One week I was working on his house, the next I was working on mine, and now that both of them are ready, I'm already working on a new build and I think you guys might like this one. You see, a lot of you guys left comments to my previous video saying that you would love to build something like that on your own, but you don't have the experience. And I do have the experience, and the time, and the equipment. So what I'm thinking is that I've been working on a glamping project here in Bulgaria for some time. And what I can do is to film every little step of how I'm building one of my glamping pods, which is basically a tiny house like this one, but smaller. So even if you don't have the experience, you can just repeat after me, and by the end you will have a beautiful tiny house to yourself. How does that sound? This guide is gonna be completely free of charge, uploaded on this YouTube channel, and for those of you guys who are really gonna go for it and build the tiny house, the blueprints, the list of materials, the detailed instructions, and even private consultations will be available. So, tell me what you think about this idea, leave your comments down below about the neighbor's house, and once again, thanks for listening to my story, it was a great pleasure indeed, and I'll see you guys next time.